Hey everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you guys my favorite foundations for oily acne prone skin. I filmed one of these back in 2017 and then I believe another one back in 2015. But I wanted to do an updated one because I feel like there's been so many great foundation launches over the last few years. I have included both drugstore and high end in here as well as light, medium, and full coverage. So depending on like your price tag and your coverage preference, hopefully you can find one that you like. I do want to mention that just because one of these foundations works for me doesn't mean that it's always going to work for everybody else, but I hope that if you are on the hunt for, you know, a new foundation, this video will help you guys out. So I do have my notes are here in front of me, so we're going to go ahead and get started, and we're going to start out with probably one of my favorites. It's the NARS Soft Matte Complete Coverage Foundation. I have the shade Light 2 Mont Blanc. It is $40 and it comes in 34 shades. Now, I do store mine in here because if you store this the other way, I've had with this packaging the foundation shoot out. So it comes in like a really nice squeezy tube, which again I think is great if you're someone who travels, which who's traveling right now, but it would make great, you know, travel friendly packaging. But I love this. It's the foundation I'm wearing today and it is so full coverage, but it's so lightweight. Like, I didn't think it was possible to get this much coverage and not feel it on my skin. It's one of those foundations that I literally forget I have on my face. This is one of the ones that I reach for right now with so much mask wearing, like, because I know it's going to last. I feel like if you're someone who doesn't like a very flat matte look, then you probably won't love this one. But if you want a matte, like smooth, flawless face, this is going to be it. But if you're someone who hates the feeling of foundation, again, I really think you're going to love this one. This one does, like I say, have full coverage. It's not the most buildable because I do feel like once you kind of start blending it out, it definitely goes ahead and starts to sit down. So if I try to go over top of it, like on my breakouts and like build up, it can kind of do that weird, like heavy kind of cakey looking. So I feel like I just go in pretty heavy. I'll like put it on the back of my hand and like go like this pretty heavily and then tap in with a sponge and I get the amount of coverage that I like. But again, it does set quickly, so you might want to work a little bit quicker. But if you want, like I said, a really nice smooth one that doesn't sink into my smile lines or my forehead lines, then this is such a great one. If you want some glow to your skin, I don't know how a hydrating primer would do underneath this, but a mattifying primer underneath this literally guarantees me that I'm not going to get any oil coming through right here. So again, that's what I've been gravitating towards. This is an awesome one, and you guys should definitely try it out if you want something super full coverage, but you don't feel it on your skin. Now we're going to jump to a drugstore one. So this is the L'Oreal up to 24 hour fresh wear foundation. I feel like L'Oreal is just such a great drugstore brand. This is $14.99 and it comes in 40 shades. I will say that this is more of a medium coverage, but this one definitely doesn't feel as lightweight. Like, I don't feel the NARS one, like I said, on my skin, but this is one that I can honestly definitely feel on my skin. It's not bad. It's not like the Pacifica one. No, not Pacifica one, the Physicians Formula one that I just reviewed. Like, that one is heavy feeling. But this one, like, I can just feel that it's on my skin. You know, it's not bad, it's not heavy feeling, but I know that it's there. But this gives really nice medium coverage. I would say it's not the most buildable because when I do try to build this over top of my acne, I just honestly feel like the coverage stays the same. I feel like this one is exactly like it says, though. It gives a very nice fresh appearance to the skin. So if you don't like that complete flat matte look, then I think that this one would be a great one. I don't have any issues of this one settling into my smile lines. I will say the only issue I've ever had with this one is I feel like for some odd reason it does settle kind of funny around my nose, but that's the only place. But again, I felt like I should mention that one. Again, if you want a very fresh feeling foundation, medium coverage, then I think that this is a nice one. If you want one that, like I said, feels a little bit more on the lightweight side, I do have another medium coverage one here in a second that I'll mention that feels a lot more lightweight. But I do have the shade 410 and 420. I feel like I could never find my perfect foundation in like the L'Oreal one, so I'm always like mixing shades. But this is a great affordable one from the drugstore if you do have oily skin. All right, moving on to a high-end one. This is the Pat McGrath Skin Fetish Sublime Perfection Foundation, and I have been raving about this foundation for like the last month or two. And I love it, guys. This is $68, which is absolutely ridiculous, but this does come in 36 shades. So when I was reading about this one and it said that this one had more of like a radiant finish, I was really scared, but I wanted to give it like a chance. Now, this is a very light coverage foundation. It comes in a really nice glass bottle and you do have a pump. But this one is very, very lightweight. Again, it's one of those that like you forget you have on your face. It's very skin-like. Like, this is one of those that, like, yes, if you're having a lot of acne and a lot of breakouts, but you just want your skin to look like skin, then like, but add some coverage if that makes sense, then this is it. It's so, so incredibly lightweight. I definitely feel like for someone who wants like more coverage, you could definitely put this and then spot conceal. So I feel like it's like very flexible. It's one of those formulas that I find I can let sit on my skin, wait, and then blend it out. It's not one of those that sets down so quickly as the NARS one does. This is light coverage though, so if you have a lot of breakouts, you might not like this one. But if you're someone who doesn't suffer from a lot of breakouts but oily skin, but you want that like skin look, because it's not like a flat matte. It's like, but I don't want to say radiant, because I feel like when you have oily skin, you hear radiant, you're like, oh my gosh. It just looks like skin that you've just moisturized, if that makes sense. It's just really nice and smooth. It doesn't settle into any fine lines, and it just is probably out of all of these the most skin-like foundation I've honestly probably ever used, and it doesn't break me out. It's just, I mean, it is such a beautiful foundation. I know it's expensive, but when I honestly say that, I feel like it's worth it if you're someone who wants light coverage, light feeling on your skin, and just to literally look like your skin, then this is going to be the perfect foundation for you. Again, I know it's expensive, but it's definitely worth it. All right, so jumping back to a drugstore foundation. So this is the Pacifica A Light Clean Foundation. This is both 100% vegan and cruelty-free. I have three shades here, but I'm just going to hold one because I feel like I'll drop these. It comes in a really nice glass bottle, and you do have a pump. I do want to, whoops, this one's going to make me a liar. There we go. So, sorry, mine's like a little bit nasty around there. But the only bad thing about this packaging-wise is I had these stored like this in my foundation's drawer because they were too tall standing up. Oil will leak out from these, so I just wanted to mention that for you guys. But this one is $16. It comes in 30 shades. This one is medium to full coverage, and this is one that you can actually build to get full coverage and to cover your acne. Now, I will be honest, it's not the most lightweight feeling, but it's not as heavy as the Physicians Formula one, but it's a foundation that you know is on your skin, and I know a lot of people don't like that. This is a satin finish, so while it's like really nice and like airbrushed, it's not one of those that's flat matte, but it's not like super dewy. It's like that perfect in between. I would describe this foundation as like the like a filter foundation. If I'm going to be taking photos, this is the foundation that I reach for. The coverage is amazing, but like I said, it just makes your skin look like you've literally put a filter over top of your face. This doesn't break me out. Again, this is one that glides really well over any dry patches I might have. It works great on my smile lines and around my nose. Again, if you want, like I said, just like a filter on your face, you should definitely try this one out because it is a great one. Oh, it does last on my oily skin, I did want to mention, but I do feel like that one benefits from a mattifying primer because I do feel like I can start to get a little bit oily in these areas. So you definitely want to wear a mattifying primer with that one. But again, if you want that really, like I said, just satin look to your skin, that one's a great one. All right, moving on to a high-end one again. This is the Too Faced Born This Way Matte Foundation. I love this foundation. It's got a really nice glass bottle as well as a pump. But this foundation reminds me most similarly to the Estee Lauder Double Wear. Like, I have never found a foundation that's so similar to that one. But the Estee Lauder Double Wear one I did figure out was breaking me out. But this one is like a great alternative. I do have the shade Pearl in this one. Now, this one is $40. It comes in 35 shades. And this one is full coverage. This is one of those that I know if I need something to last the entire day, this is the one I'm going to be gravitating towards through sweating. Like, I don't work out in foundation, but if I was going to work out in one, this would be the foundation because it's that matte. Again, if you're someone who has oily skin and acne and you don't like something that's so matte, you might want to try out one of the other ones because I really feel like this one's like, again, like that Estee Lauder Double Wear. It's a matte foundation and it's just going to last and really hang on. I do feel like I said out of all of these, this is probably the most long-wearing foundation. I do feel like this one kind of looks funny again over any kind of like dryness over my acne. So again, if I'm treating those areas, this isn't one that I reach for. I find that this one's actually buildable, but again, it kind of starts to set a little bit quicker like that NARS one, but I feel like I do have a little bit more give time to work with this one. But again, full coverage. Oh, and I do feel like while this feels like not as lightweight as the NARS one, for the amount of coverage you get, it is, I feel like, somewhat on the lighter weight side, but it's not lightweight by any means, if that makes sense. I would say that this one feels not as bad as the like Pacifica one, and that one's not bad, but like I feel like I gotta mention if you can feel them on your skin, but like you can feel this one on the skin, whereas I personally feel like I can't feel the NARS one. Now, if I didn't include this foundation, I would literally be lying because this is like probably my favorite foundation for no matter how my skin's acting up. Like, this works for me year round. It's the Soap and Glory Kick-Ass All Day Wear Foundation. Unfortunately, I believe this is being discontinued. I'm hoping they're just repackaging this one, but I cannot find the exact price of this. I'm thinking it was around like $14, but you can still find this like in random places like Walgreens and select shades. But like this is the perfect foundation for me, whether my skin is sensitive, breaking out really bad. It's like medium coverage and it gives me this gorgeous, like not matte, but not dewy, like that perfect in between, but not quite satin. Like again, very skin-like, but like with medium coverage. Like the Pat McGrath one looks like skin, but it's like this one looks like skin as well, but with double the coverage. I love it. If you can still find it, you guys should definitely check it out. And then lastly, we've got the Urban Decay Stay Naked Foundation. This one is $39 and this comes in a total of 50 shades. I would say that the coverage of this is definitely medium coverage, but this is, again, quite a lightweight foundation. I don't feel it on my skin. I actually got this because after the all-nighter one, that one, like I love that one because my skin, when I used to, like I said, I like full coverage now, but my acne like doesn't bother me as much as it used to because, you know, it is what it is. So I feel like I do gravitate towards more medium coverage foundations because they are a little bit more lightweight. So I kind of give up the all-nighter one, and my sister did as well, which was, it's a funny story, but she, like when she ran out of that one, she's like, what's a new one I should try? And I was like, try their Stay Naked. Well, she tried it and she didn't like it. But my sister's not one of those people that will return a foundation. So she used it up. And then when she ran out of this one, she went back to the all-nighter one. She's like, oh my God, I cannot wear that all-nighter one because it's too heavy feeling. So this one again is really nice and lightweight. I love this one. I think it looks good on me, like I said, year round. And something else, I mean, you guys can see this is a plastic container as well. I don't know if I mentioned that. Oh, and I am in the shade 30 and in. But this one is one of those that I feel like you can wear again like all year round. It doesn't matter if you've got like really dry areas of acne. It glides over it really well. It doesn't matter if you're extremely oily. It just works so incredibly well on my skin. Very similar to how the Soap and Glory one looks, but this one I do feel like gives me more of like that natural matte finish. I don't have like that more, I'd say, like, you know, skin-like look. It was definitely more of like a matte one. But yeah, guys, I feel like this video has definitely taken me forever and my battery is blinking. So I want to thank you guys so incredibly much for watching this video. And if you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching.